tablet. For a long time, the division has been between big and beefy at the 10-inch size and small and portable down at 7 and 8 inches. With the Xperia Tablet Z, Sony looks to bridge the gulf with a thin and light 10-inch tablet that's also waterproof. Does it succeed? Let's find out. I'm Michael Fisher, this is Pocket Now, and this is our video review of the Sony Xperia Tablet Z. When we first caught sight of the Tablet Z at MWC 2013, we were immediately smitten. Sony had pierced our veil of disinterest in 10-inch Android tablets, developing a product that looked and felt beautiful on the trade floor. We wondered, though, how much hardware fit and finish was required to overcome the 10-inch Android stigma. Well, we've spent over a week with our own Tablet Z figuring that out, so let's dive in. It's pretty tough to properly showcase the Z on film, as viewed from the front, it seems kind of unremarkable. A 10.1-inch 1920x1200 display dominates the front side, topped by a 2.2-megapixel front-facing camera and the Sony logo. Some might find the tablet's ample bezel a little excessive, but it's a godsend for one-handed usability. More on that in a second. The back is even more Spartan, offering just the Xperia branding and an NFC logo at the tap-to-share area, with the 8.1-megapixel primary camera hanging out in the upper right corner. The Tablet Z's real story is found on its sides. The unit measures only 6.9 millimeters thick. That's a full 2 millimeters thinner than Google's Nexus 10, yet Sony has still managed to cram a few necessities along that slim stretch of reflective material. The left side plays host to most of the action with a pronounced power standby button, sharing space with a volume rocker, headphone jack, and a notification LED, nice touch, but speaker and micro USB ports, a micro SD slot, and an IR transmitter make their homes on edges elsewhere. These are all covered by protective flaps to preserve the device's IP55 and 57 water and dust resistance rating. As long as those covers are closed, the Tablet Z won't mind sitting in fresh water up to a meter deep for up to 30 minutes, or being sprayed with water jets from most any direction. The screen won't work while submerged, but the device won't be hurt. That means users can take the Tablet Z on the boat or to the lake without much worry, and for such a thin and light tablet, that's quite an accomplishment. Speaking of light, the Tablet Z weighs in at just 495 grams, compared to the Nexus 10, iPad 4, and the Surface RT, all of which sit north of 600 grams on the scale. Combined with that generous bezel, the reassuring rigidity, and the comfortable soft-touch back, the lightweight makes using the Tablet Z one-handed not just possible, but a pleasure. Sony calls the aesthetic vision behind the Tablet Z the Omnibalance design, but whatever its name, it succeeds brilliantly at providing the portability of a 7-inch tablet with the screen size of a 10-inch one. And what about that screen? Well, the use of TFT LCD over AMOLED would normally mean we found colors less saturated on this panel and the blacks less deep. Now, while the latter is true, the former isn't. Colors really pop on this quote-unquote reality display, probably thanks to Sony's Mobile Bravia Engine 2, along with a very colorful selection of preloaded wallpapers. Nice move, Sony. Visibility does drop off quite a bit when viewing the panel from the side, especially considering how glossy and susceptible to fingerprints the tempered glass is, but it's still plenty watchable, it's just dimmer. Also, in a very nice touch, the screen is unlockable via a double tap when turned off. Finally, under the hood powering the experience is a quad-core Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 Pro at 1.5 GHz, backed up by 2 gigs of RAM and either 16 or 32 gigs of storage, expandable via microSD. Our unit is a Wi-Fi-only version, though an LTE variant is also available. Providing the juice to keep the lights on, a non-removable 6,000 mAh battery that takes up most of the space inside the unit. Powering the Tablet Z on reveals right away that this isn't a stock Google experience. The lock screen disappears with a window blind-like effect, and we're dropped into Sony's special build of Android 4.1.2. It looks similar to stock, but with some definite aesthetic and functional differences. Chief among them, the location of the home, back, and multitasking keys on the lower left, and the system status, settings toggles, and notification center on the lower right. This makes them handy for one-thumb access, and it makes a lot more sense than stock Android's top-of-screen positioning. There are also two persistent shortcut keys at the midpoint of the bottom row. One calls up the remote app, so you can use the Tablet Z to control your TV, cable box, DVR, or what have you. The other brings up a list of utilities Sony calls small apps, which are, you guessed it, small-scale windowed apps ranging in complexity from a calculator all the way up to a bare-bones browser. It's a bit like the pop-up apps on Samsung tablets, but on the Tablet Z, only one title can be open at a time. That feels a little confining, but not nearly as bad as having no multitasking option in the first place. If you don't like the existing selection, you can buy more small apps from the Play Store, or you can convert existing app widgets into small apps. Sony has also included a suite of custom titles it puts front and center on first power on. The album is fun to scroll through, and it includes the ability to sync with Facebook, Picasa, and other photo repositories. Movies not only hosts your local video files, but allows you to throw them to other compatible devices, and it can also fetch details about downloaded movies from the internet. The Walkman app has a brand name that still manages to inspire nostalgia, but it's a modern player for locally stored music, with large, easy-to-use controls, and everything from a visualizer to a shortcut option that lets you search for lyrics, music videos, and artist info across the web. There's also Social Life, an aggregator, a bit like a mashup of Flipboard and HTC's Blink feed, that displays news stories, tweets, and status updates from your social streams. It's a fun novelty for a second, but performance issues plague Social Life. It's always bogging down and jumping around, and not in a fun way. That's a problem that can be seen throughout the Tablet Z's interface, actually. Even simple actions like scrolling between home screens sometimes results in lag and stutter. Behavior like this is something we shouldn't be seeing on a device of this class, and it can get pretty frustrating when a swipe is interpreted as a tap, or a homepage takes forever to scroll by. Now, it's entirely possible Sony's own widgets are the lag-causing issue, and removing them does speed up the tablet. Since AOSP is now available for the Tablet Z, we can see why people would be excited to load stock Android on this thing. But we're hesitant to recommend throwing the baby out with the bathwater here. It's true that you might get more responsiveness with stock Jelly Bean on this hardware, but Sony's UI layer brings a lot to the table, ranging from fun aesthetic touches to genuinely useful additions like the repositioned buttons, small apps, and the remote control utility. Sony's software also includes some battery optimizations, which are very handy on a tablet this thin, with a battery only two-thirds the size of the one on the Nexus 10. There's Stamina Mode, which disables data, background actions, and other activities when the screen is off, and the more conventional Low Battery Mode, which includes options to disable or hobble certain features once total charge reaches a certain low power threshold. With our Tablet Z polling 2 email and 3 social media accounts, plus a variety of other services like Google Voice, we found that the unit usually drained about 10% per 8-hour overnight period. With Stamina Mode turned on, that power drain fell to less than 5% drain overnight. This isn't a tablet that you'd bring with you into the forest for a week with no charger, but it packs enough juice to last a few days with moderate to heavy use, and much longer with more conservative habits. The Tablet Z's 8-megapixel primary camera defaults to 5 megapixels out of the box, presumably to maintain a widescreen aspect ratio, and its field of view is quite narrow, forcing you to get far away from a subject before you can capture it all in the frame. The results are about what you'd expect for a tablet camera. No matter what lighting situation, we come away with fuzzy edges, colors just a bit off, and a general sense of meh. Ramping up the resolution to 8 megapixels gives us a bit more detail, and toggling HDR on brings out the midtones, but it also brings out a gray pallor. Video is similarly middle of the road. It's nice to be able to shoot in 1080p, but there's nothing outstanding here. On the bright side, unless you're a fan of reticule, you're probably going to be using the Tablet Z's camera less for scenic photos and more for document scanning, barcode reading, and the like. And at these tasks, the camera will do just fine. There are a bevy of options for adjusting the optics, and the front-facing camera actually does quite nicely in good lighting conditions, ensuring your Skype calls will go well. That's assuming you can hear one another. The Tablet Z's microphone might be a bit too sensitive, and it caused some echo on the other end of video calls during our testing. The speakers on the Z are also a little on the small side, despite their multiple corner ports. In media playback, they're fine, with S-Force Front Surround 3D producing a cool effect, but in Skype calls, they're pretty quiet. You'll want to keep some Bluetooth or wired headphones handy for communication purposes. Fortunately, the Tablet Z plays nice with those. To be clear, the Xperia Tablet Z is still a 10-inch Android tablet, with all the failings of that platform in that form factor. The app situation is still mediocre, with most popular titles built for smartphones and awkwardly stretched out on the Z, and some even forcing you into the awkward portrait orientation. The Android tablet app problem is still a very real handicap. But as we've speculated before, it may take truly beautiful Android tablet hardware to motivate developers to code great software to run on it. And in that department, the Tablet Z more than fits the bill. It's a thin, lightweight, beautifully crafted piece of technology that makes us want to overlook its failings rather than dwell on them. And don't forget, it's waterproof. While we wish its stock software were a bit more responsive, its battery a bit bigger, and its price a bit more competitive, this is still one of the most beautiful tablets we've ever handled, and one of the only Android ones we'd consider buying at the 10-inch form factor. If you run your life on Google, and you're looking for a large but portable tablet to extend your computing needs on the go, the Xperia Tablet Z deserves a long look. We give it a solid 8 out of 10. We'll have more in-depth thoughts on the Tablet Z in our written review, available at pocketnow.com starting June 3rd, and in the Pocket Now Weekly podcast and the Pocket Now You Review, both available that same week at Pocket Now. So, like this video if you did enjoy it, leave us a comment if you have something to say, subscribe to our various social feeds so you don't miss any posts about the Tablet Z or other devices that we are reviewing, and thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.